All right, so here's the deal. It was a couple of years ago, and it was just before Christmas, and I was running around trying to get, some little stocking stuffers, more or less things that I wanted to kind of go along with some other gifts that I had made. And at the time, I was looking for just a nice, simple little sled. I don't remember what it was it was supposed to be going with, but I was looking for just a nice, simple little sled. And, I do the shopping thing. I went and hit all the stores, and really, I'd swear that this is the time of year that really all the retailers and the stores, they bring out all the crap from their closets and stuff that wouldn't sell from the past years, and they put it on sale and try to pawn it off to you. But the long and short of it was is that everything that I found was just ugly. I'm sorry, I hate to say it, but it was just ugly as could be. So, I'm looking at this and I'm thinking, well, this is a pretty simple thing. I'm just, I can turn around really quick. I'm just going to make one. And so I did. And this is what I came up with. And it's just a nice, simple little sled, but it's not painted. It's not all, kind of jazzed up to try and be more than what it is. It's a sled. It doesn't need to be anything fancy, but, I did want it to be, kind of classy. Simple elegance, I guess, is a good way to put this. And this is what I came up with. And I made, I want to say in a weekend, I made 15 or 18 of these things. And I ended up, after I made the first one, I liked it so much, I made a bunch of them, turned around, and I actually gave them out as little kind of side gifts for everybody. So this is our project for today. And I hope you like it. I really hope somebody tries it. And let's get started here. What's nice about this project is that really it only consists of like two pieces. You've got the top, which is very simple, and also you've got two skis that you cut out. And both of these pieces are something that you can cut out with a jigsaw, a handsaw, a bandsaw. Obviously is going to be easiest, but really you have a few options as far as how you can get these pieces cut out. And after you've got the main pieces done, then it's just, at that point, it's just detailing. Another little sliver across the top here, just to kind of dress it off a little bit. And this is one that I made real quick yesterday, just, so that I had something to show you as far as what we're making. But the one that we're going to be making for the show here, I'm going to finish a little bit differently, just in case you don't have, like some of these, I put in little mahogany bungs or, plugs in here to kind of dress it up a little bit, again, because I like contrasting woods. But I'm going to do the one for the show here is a little bit different, and we're going to use just a regular hardware store stain, like a regular Ace stain, and just some small screws with some finish washers. And again, it's going to jazz it up, and it's going to look really nice. So the dimensions for these pieces, the main top, this one is roughly 10 and a half inches long and 6 3/4 inches wide. And for both of these pieces, I'm using half inch stock. Now for the top specifically, if you don't have a solid piece of wood that's this wide, take some strips and glue it up. It'll look really sharp. I think I mentioned this last time. If you've got some neat woods laying around, just the little scraps that you've been kind of saving for that, I don't want to throw it away just in case I can find a use for it. Right here. You can take a bunch of little strips, glue them up, and really it'll look very unique. People will love it, and it'll look really nice. Now, as far as the ski, let me see here. The ski itself is roughly 13 and a half inches long and about 1 3/4 inches thick, at its thickest points right here and here. So to get started, let's take our templates, lay them out on some wood, and trace them out. By the way, I'm going to be meeting with my web guy today, and I'm hoping to get our site up this week. And I'm going to have the plans for the sleds as well as the plans for the tugboat available online to download. So hopefully we can get it all pulled together in time. So here I'm going to be using just a little piece of half-inch poplar, and you get this traced out real quick. You can see how quickly this goes. So at this point, it's just going to be a little bit of hand sanding to, you know, take off any saw kerfs that you know, got on the wood when we were cutting it out, and ease the edges. I mean, if you wanted to use a router, if you have a router with a small bit, you could certainly use that for rounding over all these edges here. But you know, to be honest, I think these are nice small little pieces. I think it'd be just as easy to do it by hand. So a good block. And I'm going to be using some 220 here. If you want to start with some 80, if you have a little bit more material to remove, you know, certainly do that. But I was able to cut pretty close to the line, so I think I'm just going to be going with some 220, and we'll be ready to glue up here in a little bit. All right, now that I've got all the pieces sanded down and the edges rounded over and that kind of thing, I think I want to stain the top. Usually I stain the skis, but I don't know. I think I want to do the top this time, just to do something a little bit different. And I'm going to be using this. It's Minwax. The name of the stain is Jacobean or color 2750. So I'm just going to take a little brush and just really load it on. Let it soak in for probably like 5 minutes or so. And then I'm gonna wipe it off, even out the color of the stain, and let it sit for a little bit. And it's going on much darker than how it's actually gonna look when I actually start to wipe it off. So I've let this sit on here for really not that long, just maybe 2-3 minutes or so. And I just want to see how it's starting to take shape here. There, I like it. This is probably one of my favorite colors of stain, and just kind of a neat little effect. You know, you can see the top. You can still get see the grains of the wood coming through real nice, and the end grains they're going to be darker. You know, that's the nature of staining an end grained piece of the wood. But I think it looks sharp. You know, I might come back and maybe touch these sides a little bit more to kind of even it out, or well, maybe not. Just you know, kind of leave it a little rustic looking. I don't know. I like it. So I'm gonna let this dry for a few more minutes, and then I'll flip it over and stain the other side. Yeah, I like that color. That looks nice. I think I'm just gonna leave it the way it is. I like this color. Grains look nice. And the sides, I don't know. I like character. I think I'm going to leave it. things, I don't know, things to me that are just absolutely perfect, they don't look right. They don't have any character to them. So I like to leave little things like this for some things. Other things I like to have it perfect, but this isn't one of those things. This is an arts and craft thing. So I think while the top of the sled is drying, I'm going to go ahead and cut one little trim piece that runs across the top. Just doesn't really serve any purpose other than as an accent. So I'm going to do some very precise measuring here. And yep, that's what I'm cutting off. So here's my little piece that I so accurately measured. And all I did was basically just round it all over. And again, that's a pretty scientific thing. Now you've got to really watch what you're doing. Now I want to get a feel for where these skis are going to mount on the sled here. And again, I'm just going to eyeball it. But if I had to guess it real quick, I'd say roughly this edge right here on the ski is maybe about an inch in from the edge on here. So I'm just going to kind of center it a little bit and make my mark on the inside, because that's going to be less visible. Now with each of these areas marked where I'm going to be drilling through to mount the skis, I am going to make a little dent for my drill to follow so that it doesn't drift off. And what works great for that? It's the tip of a compass. Pretty high tech. So the last thing I'm going to do on here before I actually drill my holes is I want to make sure that all these holes are kind of in line. So I'm going to take my square, set it up on here, and check my dots, or my pre-drill spots. And that's pretty darn close. Yeah, pretty darn close. Good enough for who it's for. And it's for me. Well, I think she's starting to take shape here a little bit. So the last thing for me to do here to finish the sled off is to get this little accent piece glued into place. So I'm just going to apply a very thin bead of glue here because I don't want it to squeeze out too much because then it's going to get all over my stain. But I want to make sure that I've got enough on here so that it stays put. And I'm kind of thinking right about there. So I'm gonna hold this in place for a minute or two. I'll put a clamp on it and let the clamp do its thing for probably 10, 15 minutes, and I'll pull it off. And then I think it's going to be time to start spraying some finish on this and calling it done. So there is our finished but unfinished sled. So let me grab some lacquer and finish this bad boy off. All right, I think I'm gonna let that sit up for a little bit. We'll flip it over and we'll do the backside. All right, well, there we go. I think it turned out pretty nice. You know, like I said, it's nothing real fancy. I think the one I made yesterday, that was made out of maple and mahogany. So, you know, a little richer woods, a little better looking grain patterns in them, but the building process is still the same. So if you've got some interesting woods, something fun to try.